Here we want to determine the equation of the linear function given f of negative 1 equals negative 7 and f of 2 equals negative 2. When given function values in function notation, we need to recognize that if f of negative 1 equals negative 7, the input or the x value is negative 1 and the output or the function value or y would be negative 7. So if f of negative 1 equals negative 7, this means our line would contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 1 and a y-coordinate of negative 7. And if f of 2 equals negative 2, then the input or x is equal to 2, and the output or function value or y-value is equal to negative 2, which again means our line would contain the point with an x-coordinate of positive 2 and a y-coordinate of negative 2. Now that we've identified two points on our line, we can find the equation of the line. The first step will be to determine the slope of the line, which we can find using the slope formula here, given two points. And then we can find the y-intercept, or the value of b, by using the slope-intercept form of a line or the point-slope form of a line. Let's start by finding the slope. So this will be x sub 1 and y sub 1. And this will be x sub 2 and y sub 2. So the slope of our line will be y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So y sub 2 minus y sub 1 will be negative 2 minus negative 7. X sub 2 minus x sub 1 will be 2 minus negative 1. Well, minus negative 7 becomes plus 7. Negative 2 plus 7 is equal to positive 5. And then 2 minus negative 1 becomes 2 plus 1, or positive 3. So this is the slope of our line. And for this example, let's go ahead and use the point slope form of a line to determine our linear equation. So we're going to use the slope, and let's go ahead and use this point here for the point slope form. So we'll have y minus the y coordinate of negative 2, well, minus negative 2 will be plus 2, equals the slope, which is 5/3, times the quantity x minus x sub 1, which is positive 2, so we have x minus 2. Now we'll clear the parentheses by distributing, solve this for y, and then write it using function notation. So the next step, we'll distribute here. So we have y plus 2 equals 5/3 x. Then we'd have what, minus, this is 2 over 1, so minus 10/3. And let's go ahead and subtract 2 on both sides of the equation. So we'll have 5/3 x minus 10/3 minus 2 over 1. Here we'll have to have a common denominator, which will be 3. So we'll multiply this fraction by 3 over 3. So we have y equals 5/3 x. This will be negative 10/3 minus 6/3, which will be minus 16/3. And then for the last step, because they want a linear function, we'll go ahead and replace y with f of x. So our linear function will be f of x equals 5/3 x minus 16/3.